sometimes life is like a tug of war. So Maddie is a Jesus follower, and I'm going to be like Satan. And sometimes Satan tries to pull us into sin, and he pulls us over the line. But Jesus gave us the Spirit after he died and went to heaven. He sent the Spirit of God, and the Spirit helps us to say no to sin. So now Katrina's going to help Maddie, and we'll see how the tug of war goes. Beat me.
Wait, you.
So let's praise God for the gift of his Spirit.
Just John 3:30.
Today's story comes from the book of Luke, and it tells us more about Jesus' life when he was a man on earth. Today, Satan is going to try and get Jesus to make a bad choice. Let's watch and see what Jesus does.
Hello, friends. I'm Megan.
And I'm Jesse.
Jesse, what's wrong? You seem a little down.
I am. I got in trouble for riding my bike in the street, so my dad took my bike away.
Oh, again, Jesse?
Yeah, it's just so hard, Megan. I know it's dangerous, but I get going so fast and I just want to go a little bit further.
I understand, Jesse. We are sinners, so we want to sin. But we have someone who can help us say no to sin.
We do?
Yes, Jesus. In today's Bible story, Jesus was tempted to sin, but he did not sin. Because Jesus never sinned and was punished for us, God will forgive us when we sin. We can even ask Jesus to help us not sin, and he will help us.
Wow, that's good news! I'm gonna ask Jesus to help me not ride my bike in the street.
Great idea, Jesse. Now, let's listen to the story. After Jesus was baptized, God's Spirit led him into the wilderness. Jesus stayed in the wilderness for many days. He prayed to God and thought about God's plan for his life. Jesus did not eat anything while he was in the wilderness, and he was very hungry. The devil came to tempt Jesus. He tried to get Jesus to do wrong things. The devil said, "If you are really God's son, tell these stones to become bread." If Jesus used his power to turn the stones into bread, he could eat the bread. Then he wouldn't be hungry anymore. But Jesus said no. He trusted God to give him what he needed. Then Jesus said, "This is what the Bible says. Man must not live only on bread, but on all the words God says." Jesus did not sin, so the devil tried again. He took Jesus to the top of the temple in Jerusalem. The devil said, "If you are really God's son, prove it. Jump off the top of the temple. God will protect you." Then the devil said, "The Bible says God will order his angels to keep you safe, and they will protect you so that you will not even trip on a stone." Again, Jesus said no. Jesus knew the devil was trying to trick him by misusing God's words. The devil was being foolish. Jesus said, "The Bible also says, do not test God." Finally, the devil took Jesus to a high mountain where they could see land stretched out far and wide. The kingdoms in the land were great. The devil said, "Look, I will give you all the money and power of these great kingdoms. All you have to do is fall down and worship me." Jesus said, "No, go away," he said. "The Bible says, only worship God and only serve God." So the devil went away. Angels came to help Jesus and serve him. In all of these things, Jesus never sinned. The devil tried to get Jesus to sin, but Jesus never sinned. Jesus always did the right thing. Jesus died on the cross to rescue us from sin. When we are tempted to sin, we can ask Jesus to help us say no to sin.
The devil doesn't like Jesus, and he tried to get Jesus to do what God didn't want him to do, so that Jesus couldn't save us. But did Jesus listen to the devil? No. He said no to sin. Jesus always obeys God perfectly. And that's why Jesus came to save us. Because we sometimes make bad choices, don't we? And so Jesus made all the right choices so that he could save us from our bad choices. We are so thankful to Jesus. And now Jesus gives us power through the Spirit of God to say no to sin. Thank you, Jesus. I hope that you can answer some of these questions from our story today. And keep learning about Jesus, and we'll see you here next time.